Yeah, they better not kill off this badass bitch.
Hey, what's up, guys? Spencer Rhodes here. So I have just been so happy that Rosita survived season 9. I never thought it would happen. I always thought she would get her comic death, and I knew that the heads on spikes was going to happen in season 9. Like, structurally, that's just pretty plain and obvious. Season 8 was going to be all at war. Season 9 was going to be a new beginning, and eventually, probably in the last episode, they would do the heads on spikes. It's just too precious of a thing to not do in season 9. It's sort of like, just like it was basically the next Lucille, Glenn, the next Negan introduction, and I just had a feeling they were going to do it in season 9. They weren't going to wait until later. They weren't going to skip over it. Well, obviously they weren't going to skip over it. That would have been bullshit, especially with all the characters they had. You could obviously, kill some of the expendable characters. And I really did think that Rosita was going to get her comic death. I didn't want Glenn and Abraham to die like the comics, and they died like the comics. Abraham was slightly different, but he lived 5 minutes later. But, so what? So I'm happy that Rosita survived season 9, but what if she is like Abraham? Abraham survived his comic death and then died, what, 2 episodes later? Yeah, just 2 episodes later. And Rosita has survived an episode after the episode with the heads on spikes. She survived the finale, and the heads were in episode 15. So Rosita's going to be in season 10. That's pretty much guaranteed. But she could die in the first 5 minutes. She could die in the first episode. She very well could be the next Abraham. I mean, after all, season 10 is going to need deaths. It's going to kill characters off. Characters that survive season 9 are being saved for next year. That's always how The Walking Dead has done things. There's characters that die every single season. So yeah, Rosita could get her comic de- well, not get her comic death, but Rosita could just die 5 minutes after her comic death, and so can Ezekiel. The same thing can happen to Ezekiel. I mean, for all we know, Ezekiel and Rosita die in the first episode of season 10, or maybe it's one in episode 1, one in episode 2. It would be nice if they lived at least until like the middle of the season. With Rosita, I just think the actress is just so good, and she's just so awesome, and Rosita is so interesting. And her surviving her comic death, that's a big one. That's a win. For Rosita fans, including myself, that's a big win. It would be nice to not just completely get shit on and her die 5 minutes later anyway, because that's what they did with Abraham. And like Abraham, we have to wait the 6 months to find out. We don't know how far she's going to make it into season 10. I'm hoping it's at least the middle. Honestly, I would rather her survive the season. If she can survive her comic death, why can't she make it to season 11? Why not? I mean, another thing is that they really shouldn't kill her off 5 minutes later than her comic death, because I feel like, in a way, Rosita and Ezekiel were traded. They were specifically traded for other characters. I feel like if they didn't kill off Tara for the heads on spikes, they would have killed off Rosita. In fact, I think Rosita was a red herring for a lot of the scenes in the season. And I really felt like they were setting up her death, because they were almost giving her like a really happy thing with Gabriel, and I was just like, oh shit, that means she's gonna die. That literally happened with Abraham and Sasha, other characters, Tyrese and Karen. So yeah, I thought that maybe they were setting up Rosita's death. But they literally made her the red herring. When they actually showed the heads on spikes, they had Gabriel and Eugene talking to each other, and as if it was Rosita, and then boom, it's Tara's head. So they did it on purpose. You can't say they didn't do it on purpose. They knew most people were expecting Rosita to die, and they were like, ah, just kidding, bitches, it's Tara. And I can appreciate that. I can respect that as a trade. I want it to be more than like an April Fool's prank, though. I want it to be like they've switched, not switched, but they traded those characters. Maybe Tara could have lived seasons onward if this hadn't happened, but they killed her for the heads on spikes. So in return, maybe Rosita gets to live years longer. Because I did feel like Tara was a character that had a lot of potential. She just became the leader of what, Hilltop, if I remember. And I think I always loved her character. I always supported her character. I think she had more potential as someone who could have lived a few more years longer and had a relevant role as one of the leaders. But nope, that's right when she gets that stuff, she gets killed. So I feel like if you're gonna end Terra, then yeah, leave Rosita alive for a long time. You know, have Rosita live to season 11, season 12, season 13. And I think a lot of people might feel better about Terra's death because, like I said, you if you're going to trade those two characters, then actually make it worth it and keep Rosita alive for a long time. I mean, who's going to get sick of Christian Serratos? I mean, she's just awesome and badass, and I think Rosita's really cool. And at this point, she's becoming one of the longest-living characters. She might have been introduced in the back half of Season 4, but we have five or six other people on the show right now that have lived that long. Terra was one of them, and you know she was killed. And unless you include the MIA ones like Rick, Maggie, Morgan, but they're not in the show, so I'm kind of excluding them. If you exclude those three, then Rosita is one of the longest running characters on the show right now. Like I said, Terra was one of them, but they got rid of her. I say just make it worth it and keep Rosita alive until like season 13. Maybe more, who knows? That'd be pretty cool. But yeah, I hope Rosita at least survives season 10, and I sure as fuck hope it's not 5 minutes later than her comic death like Abraham was, because I just feel like that's a slap in the face, especially if you've just killed big characters like Terra, Enid, Henry. We should have more time with Rosita after that. Anyway, I mean, yeah, like, because otherwise, why not just give her comic death? You know, why not? If you're not going to let her live that much longer anyway, then why not keep Terra alive and just give Rosita her comic death? Boom, you know, solution. But no, they took the time to kill Terra and keep Rosita alive, so they better not do that Abraham crap where she just dies a different death 5 minutes later. They better not. Anyway, that's all I have for this video. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Don't be shy. Hit that like and subscribe. I'm not going anywhere. I make 1 to 2 Walking Dead videos per day, so please hit that subscribe button. Right now we are at 540 subscribers. My goal is to try to get to 600 in the next few months. So just remember, every subscriber counts, every bit of support matters, and is really, really appreciated. Hopefully we can get to that goal of 600. Anyway, with all that said, I am Spencer Rhodes, and I will see you guys later. Bye!